everybody. I am recording from my phone again, and only because I am desperate. I need to get away from the family to videotape this, or else it's never going to get done. So this is my design team project for Luisa Diaz digital kit. And first of all, let me tell you, if you cannot see it from there, this kit is amazing. I love it. It had everything there for you. So it's just like, seriously, all you have to do is cut and glue. It's just amazing. It's just like the romance novel paper where you have to, everything's already done for you. So it was simple. It was just as simple as that. So this is what I made with my design team kit. And I will link the link down below in the description box. Here I just use some seam binding and some ribbon. I love the colors. Oh my gosh. I love it. Okay. So that's the cover that's done on some acetate paper. And over here I have this attached because I'm going to be attaching a charm. But it hasn't been done yet. I will do it. This is the first page, and I didn't want to ruin these papers because I'm going to be putting pictures here. So I use acetate paper. I had to come up with a clever way to do that. Isn't that paper gorgeous? Oh my gosh. I inked up all the edges. It is so pretty as is. You don't even have to add glossy accents or anything. Everything I used here is included in the kit. This description word that says treasure is in there. This little fan is in there. All these tags, you guys, are all in there. I've been trying to film this for 2 days, and it's just been so hard to get that time. And then this frame is included there. And you can just pull out here with this tag here, which I don't want to try with one hand. And then on to the next page. Like I said, everything's included in there, including this. Isn't this gorgeous? Oh, it's so gorgeous. And these butterflies and this little journaling card. I really didn't want to mess up the paper. I just ended up gluing everything on the acetate paper on some of them, so I can't add pictures to the real paper. I think this is my favorite one. Gorgeous! I hope you guys can't hear the kids. The kids are like horsing around outside. Okay. Another opportunity for a picture here. These gorgeous vintage stamps, they're included. This beautiful tag is included. These little envelopes are all included. All I had to do was cut them and fold them up. Everything's in there. This is in there. And this whole kit, seriously, you guys, is less than what you would pay for a small 6x6 paper pad. I mean, and all, it's at your tips, fingertips. I popped out of this butterfly here. And this is part of that for journaling. Isn't that gorgeous? I love how she hid the little images over here. They're behind the flowers. And here's another page for a big size picture here. Okay, and these papers are all, I cut them down to a little less than 8x8. And my black cardstock is 10x10, I believe. Look at this pocket watch. I love it. The word collector. This is part of the kit with the little buttons. And in here, Trying to do it with one hand, which I can never do. This is part of the kit. This is part of the kit. Love is a treasure all on its own. Post-it card. Postcard is included. I distressed and crinkled up all the paper. Look at that paper, you guys. Oh my gosh, isn't it gorgeous? I love it. I'm going to be making a day journal out of it. I just wanted to post this up first because then I'll never get... If I start the other one, it's not going to get posted till maybe next week. Here, I ended up ripping this by by accident. And so it wasn't going to be even, and I didn't want to print another one because I need more ink in my printer. So I thought, how am I going to cover this up? And what better way to cover it up than to stitch it? So I ended up stitching it up. And you know what? It doesn't look bad. I really, really like it. If I didn't tell you, I don't think you would have known. But yeah, I didn't do it on purpose. I actually ended up ripping it. I tore it when I was trying to distress it. See, I was trying to distress it here with all the white. And it kind of peeled a little, so then I pulled it. And it was just like a cuticle. You don't ever want to pull those. I ended up tearing more. So I got so mad, I just ended up ripping it off, the whole thing. And I didn't want that paper to go to waste. And it actually looks really nice. I really, really like it. Here is another stamp from the collection. And you get tons of these. So many of these. And then here you have another frame. I put the tag on acetate paper. So you can just pull it out. Stick it back in. And then here's another page. Isn't this kit full of like, I don't know, it's these gorgeous vintagey, oh my gosh, little images. I love it. I was so excited to use it. And here's this dove here. You can put a title there. I love these vintage boots. Look at those boots. Gorgeous. Now we've come to the last page. Here, I was going to put a picture here. I already had it ready, but I didn't want only one page to have pictures. So I left it like this. Here, I just used a doily, inked it up. And one of the buttons that's included in the kit. And this envelope is included in the kit. And I just glued this here, this gorgeous gem. I think that's the only thing I'm going to be adding glossy accents to. And then, am I holding it upside down? Yes, I am. Harumi, duh. Look at that. Okay. I can hear the kids. They're up to something. They're planning something. So I hope you guys like it. It is a pretty big. Let me see. What can you see that's big? Well, here's my hand. And it's pretty big. So that's it for that project. And then I have another project to share with you guys. I thought these were really cute and simple. I'm just trying to think of, I don't know if you saw my last video with the little calendar for my Free Spirit Productions entry, which, by the way, you guys, I made it into the design team for Free Spirit Productions, so I'm so excited for that. I've been thinking of little things to, like little stocking stuffers or little presents to give out, and I came up with this, and I'm going to be making a bunch of these. All I did was buy the frame for like a dollar, and then I put in... This is included in the digital kit for Luisa Diaz. All I did was tie a bow, glued on a flower. I'll probably be adding a pearl in the middle. And that's it. You can even put a picture here if you want. So this is not just a picture frame. This can also hold your post-its. Like so. You can have it on your desk. A cute post-it holder. Isn't that cute? That is so cute. If you want a bigger one, they have these in bigger size. I just thought it's so cute that they're so tiny. So, that's it for that. I also made a tag using a bunch of Prima stuff on the front side. We won't focus too much on this. But the back side is what I wanted to show you. I used everything from her kit here. This pocket watch is from Luisa Diaz Digital Kit. And this gorgeous tag is from her digital kit. This spoon is from her digital kit. I inked it up with some... I used the metallic bronze Tim Holtz distressing ink. And some, what is that? Perfect Pearls. To give it that effect. And then I use these punched out butterflies. And that's all the gorgeous stuff I made using Luisa Diaz digital kit, you guys. I hope you guys like it. Let me know what you guys think. All right, guys. Hope you guys all have a great weekend. Bye.